What's up, guys? All right, guys, so today we're doing something fun. We're actually experimenting. I just wanted to get the feel for the gun and just spraying paint on a panel. Another reason why I'm doing this is just to, like, just kind of show you the whole process that I'm going with the Samurai, because I was gonna get it painted by somebody professionally, but you know what? I mean, I'm doing everything else to the car, so I figured, you know what? I want to be able to say that everything on the Samurai was done by me. So, I mean, that's just, I guess, a personal thing that I wanted to be able to say. So yeah, and then that, and just to, you know, show you guys, the process, what it takes, and what kind of results that you can get. Like I said, this bad boy is 1.3, is what you want when you're spraying, like, sealers, base coat, and clear. Basically, I mean, you don't have to have a gun for everything. Use the same gun, which I'm doing here. Just in about 5 more minutes, we're gonna be able to spray the base coat, and so that's what we're gonna do next. All right, stay tuned. All right, guys, so I got a little too excited. I forgot to record when I put the first coat, but that's the first coat, and I'm gonna let it flash off, and then we're gonna have the second coat, and I'll show you this time. This color does have metallic in it, so what I've been told is they need to do what's called a drop coat. Basically, what you do when you do the third coat is gonna be a drop coat. Basically, what you do is you drop your pressure, like I want to say maybe like 8 pounds, 8 PSI, yeah, pounds per square inch. And you get further away from the panel, and kind of what you're doing is you're just misting on a third layer. And basically what I've been told what that does is it makes sure that you don't get no blotchiness or just make sure that the metallics spread around the panel nice and evenly and everything looks good and you get the coverage that you want. So right now I'm gonna do the second coat, which is a wet coat, and then yeah, we'll go from there. So right here you can see that I'm kind of looking at the panel. I'm not liking exactly what's laying down on the panel. So at this point I kind of realized, okay, something's not right. I'm not liking the way it's looking. So I check my pressure. I just decide to add a little bit more coats to see if I could help hide those imperfections that I'm seeing. And so yeah, in the next segment you'll see where I kind of just I realize what's going on, and yeah, well, I'll let you guys just take a look and just watch. And there you could see right off the bat, the worst thing that could happen to you when spraying metallics, you have tiger stripes, and that's exactly what I got. At this point, I'm freaking out. I'm like, dang it. You know, I'm having second thoughts, like, what the heck? Why did I do this? What's going on? Why is this happening? You know, I'm thinking everything is correct and I'm doing it the right way, but obviously by the bad results, something's not right. So I just decide, you know what, let's keep spraying. Let's see what happens. And here I go. literally watching this video, I started noticing what my problem was. And I'm basically doing three things that are super wrong and I shouldn't do. First off, I'm not overlapping each pass enough. So that's what creates those dry spots and gives me those streaks, or tiger stripes, as people call them. Also, I noticed that I'm a little bit too close to the panel. I needed to be a little bit further away. So that's the second thing I'm doing wrong. And then the third thing is I'm actually moving a little too slow. So I'm applying too much material, and that's what's giving me that unevenness. And so here is where I kind of realize things aren't going great. So check it out.
Fuck. All right, guys, so it didn't go so well. Oh, shit. Okay, so, yeah, we kind of fucked up.
So this part's hilarious to me. I'm still in disbelief. I can't believe what I'm seeing. And so I grab my light and I'm kind of just going over the hood. And I'm like, no, maybe I'm just seeing things. It's probably the angle of the light. And I get up and close and personal and I see it. And no, it's not the lighting. It's nothing. It's my technique. I just wasn't doing it correctly. I wasn't overlapping enough, moving too slow. And also, I don't know if you noticed, I was doing like random patterns. Like at one point I didn't go all the way across the hood, and I kind of went like in a little area. And if you pay attention, that area is darker. And because of the fact that I'm putting more material in that specific area, that's why. So yeah, it's hilarious, man. I was just like, dang, I messed this up. This is done. But you know, we'll see. I actually had to add a couple layers of more paint on top of that, and I corrected myself. I moved faster. I spaced myself further away from the panel, and the drop coat, I did it really nice, and that's what actually corrected all these things that are going wrong with the paint job. And then you'll see in the next video where it's corrected and it's nice and even and it's ready for clear.
All right, so here I'm going to start applying the two coats of clear. I'm setting up the gun to the pressure that I feel like will be the best. So here I start with the first coat.
I got my clear mixed up here, so that's ready to go. My gun is set up to the proper pressure. So yeah, basically let me explain to you what I just did. I applied the first coat of clear, and basically I didn't go too heavy on this coat. I kind of just made sure I got the material onto the panel. That's what I wanted. And then you know, because there is some dry spots and, you know, some spots where, you know, it could have used a little bit more clear, but I'm not too worried about that because that's what my second coat is going to be. I'm actually going to slow down a little bit more and make sure I flow it out a little bit more so it can actually get that shine that I'm looking for, and it lays down nice and flat.
But basically, this first coat, what it's gonna be is kind of like a glue. It's gonna allow the second coat to grab on like a lot nicer, so I could spray a little bit more with more confidence and spray more of it without it having having like runs in the clear. So you don't want, obviously you don't want runs. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna do right now. I'm gonna start spraying the second coat, and that should be it. Just letting it dry after that, and then see what it looks like tomorrow in the sunlight. So like I said, this is a learning process for me. Never done this before, so I really hope it comes out good, and I guess we'll see tomorrow in the sun. But right now, we're gonna spray the second coat, and we're gonna get to it. Went through the whole process and everything like that. So I want to tell you a little bit about my expectations, how I felt about it, and just you know, how it felt, you know, spraying the color on there, the clear, you know, what was my thought process you know, when I was doing it. What did I expect? I expected it to be easier, honestly. I'm not even lying to you. I was like, man, just seeing all these YouTube videos, like, I'm like, dude, this thing is easy. But it's not as easy as it looks. I'll tell you that right now. I did run into some issues. Like I said, I'm being transparent here, letting you guys know everything, how it went. When it came with like the control of the gun, the actual like sweeping motion, I actually felt really comfortable for some reason. I mean, I feel like, you know, it's not too hard to keep the gun away from the panel at a consistent distance. I believe that's not too hard. I feel like that was pretty easy to me. I felt comfortable doing it. Honestly, it's crazy. You wouldn't believe it. Spraying the clear was super easy compared to spraying the base coat. That's pretty crazy to me. I thought it was gonna be the other way around. And then I guess for the gun itself, it's a Spectrum Black Widow HTE with 1.3 tip. This gun actually laid down the paint really well. It laid down the clear really well. Like, it's really impressive. Like, I've never sprayed before, so I can't really compare it to like more expensive guns and stuff like that. So of course I know there's other guns that could do a way better job or whatever the case may be, but man, it performed really well for me. I really liked how it laid it down.
All right guys, there it is. This is the next day. We're out in the sun. As you can see, wow. On the areas where the panel was nice and flat, you could see the true finish of this hood. And man, let me tell you, it came out phenomenal. I love how it came out. And as you can see, I'm super happy that there was no streaks. Like I said, I did come up with that problem. And it came down to my technique of spraying it. I'll show you the close-ups, man. This metallic laid down really, really good, and it's nice and even, like I was saying. Looks good. The clear as well looks great, man. So now I'm excited to see what I could do inside of a paint booth where there's no trash and debris flying in the air. So it'll be much cleaner,
much cleaner when it comes to all those little specks of dirt that you see. That won't really be an issue, or at least not as bad. And obviously, of course, with the straight panel, because like I said, I didn't fix no dents on it. So, man, I'm really impressed at what I was able to do. So yeah, we're gonna go from here. I'm definitely gonna be choosing a different color. I did not like this color. I don't know how it looks good in video, but in person it looks more of like a purple, and that's not what I was going for. So I'm glad I just got a small amount of paint, so I don't have just random paint left over. So yeah, thanks for checking it out, guys. I'll give you some shots.
There she is, guys. She's all done, nice and finished. This was a super cool experience. I loved how it came out. And yeah, well, I mean, this is just the start of it. You know, just gonna get a little bit more practice, and you know, I feel pretty comfortable with Spray the Samurai. So this is what we were able to accomplish. And again, thank you guys for watching. I appreciate the support, and I'll see you guys soon in the next video.